And welcome back to Badminton Europe's live coverage of the Scottish Open Grand Prix from Emirates Arena here in Glasgow. My name is Craig Robertson and I will be joined later on by Dan Travers. We've got a single match from the quarter-final stage with Ayumi Mine from Japan against Scotland's Kirsty GILMOUR. And looking at the world rankings here, Ayumi Mine is currently ranked 129 in the world rankings, whereas Kirsty GILMOUR is currently sitting at number 20, so 100 places of a difference. But again, you can always expect a good competition from Japanese players, and I'm sure we're going to see that tonight. So I'm looking at results of Ayumi. So far, only played 5 or 6 events in the last year on the world circuit. Also looks like this is possibly her first visit to European soil. On the other hand, we're looking at Kirsty GILMOUR, Scottish and British number one. Been in quite good form recently, has won the Yonex Dutch Open, Prague Open, and was also runner-up in the Belgian International. As the Japanese player goes 2-0 up, already you can see the desire, I think the ranking of 129. I'm sure going by the last couple of rallies, I'm sure that'll start to develop. She looks very, very efficient. Wow. Nice cross reverse there by Kirsty GILMOUR. Thank you. Again, quite a patient rally there by the Japanese player. I think we can expect some long rallies in at this sort of level. Kirsty is well known throughout World Badminton for her ability to jump and hit good angles, so I'm sure the Japanese girl have done some homework to prevent this from happening. Wow. Nice cross cut there by Gilmour. And really going forward, looking for the net. At the moment, Kirsty is hitting with the drift, so it's much faster hitting from her direction. And I think a good strategy would be to be attacking the whole time going forward, but she needs that control on the net. Excellent smash there, just being patient, looking to try and get the lift from her opponent and then taking the opportunity in the cross court. Again, Kirsty coming forward, taking control of the net there. I think that the singles, especially on the side that she's at, she needs to control the net, hit down and look to come forward. Excellent net there by Kirsty. I'd say the match started pretty even, but Kirsty's managing to control the net and go forward with that attack. I think that's, we're going to see a lot more of that. Again, using the low serve and looking for the opponent to hit up to her.
She's very small, this girl, Craig, and I feel if Kirsty attacks with smashes that are close to the line at all, this girl will struggle.
Yeah, I mentioned earlier, Dan, that Kirsty's at 20 in the world, and Ayumi Mine is at 129, so there is quite a difference, but the Japanese girl is very capable. quite interesting there, the Japanese girls choosing to high serve into the drift and allowed Kirsty to attack, allowing her to jump, and we know that that's definitely a strength of hers. Again, you can see the jump smash there by Gilmour and being fairly accurate down the line, just taking it away from the Japanese player.
That's possibly just the drift taking that just out, reverse from Kirsty's forehand, played slow, soft shot, and the drift may just have affected it and pulled it just out of court.
Good attack again, taking it up the skies cross court and really going forward looking for it. Not a bad start by Gilmour, 11-7 up.
Yep, and looking comfortable and very quick. As I said, any time she hits hard and close to the line, the Japanese girl is under all sorts of pressure to try and do anything with it. And by that I mean even get to it. Because she's got variation, etc., overhead, Kirsty, so I think she'll be all right here, and we're looking for a good performance in the second part of this first set.
Yeah, Dan, I'm looking just again at her, the Japanese players. Are you mind's results? As I said, she's only played, six tournaments this year. Semi-final of the Osaka International, but again, she's sort of Yonex Japan Open. Last 16, which is good going, and played in the Chinese Grand Prix, Victor Korea Master. So she's played some tough tournaments, but this seems to be her first time outside Asia. So Kirsty's probably got 50 or 60 international events behind her, and that experience should probably tell in this match. Lucky by the Japanese player, a good rally, quite patient. I think just sometimes got to take that opportunity to hit the court, be a bit safer. Again, at the moment we're 8-12, but I think we've got another issue with the scoreboard. The on-screen scoreboard's still at 7-11, but we're actually 8-12.
It'll be interesting for me, Craig, when they turn, if the the Japanese girl continues to serve high. That was a poor shot from Kirsty. That's I would say that's the first poor shot that I've seen her play here. Just a little bit of loss of focus there, I think, on the execution of the shot. Smash at the body, see where it comes back. It's not going back to the back of the court. Oh, now Kirsty thinks that was out, but called in. Oh, it looked into me. But at my age, I can barely see the lines these days. That was clearly out. So 13-10. Good net from the Japanese player. Japanese girl and well up from Kirsty and good. Some lovely shots there from both players before Kirsty finished it with that smash. Just not getting it to the back of the court. Lovely picture there of the Japanese girl splitting her defensive position there as Kirsty struck the shuttle. Just once or twice, Kirsty just loses a little bit of focus on the execution of a shot. Because that goes down as an unforced error. You've got the shuttle in the air and you're in control. She's lifted that out, so she's maybe under a little more pressure than we think, Craig. It's, it is difficult out there, especially when you're the top seed all the time. Everybody's out to get you. If I didn't know how fit Kirsty was, I'd say that looked like a tired shot, but see her weight all wrong, the balance not there. She should have been landing and coming forward. So it's closer than I expected this to be at this moment in time. And now it's 14 all. I just feel Kirsty's just defensive, too defensive. I know when you're attacking, it takes more out of you, obviously, but I feel she does have a good attack, and I think she's going to have to start using it rather than playing the shuttle around the court.
I think especially when she's on the faster side, Dan. I think like many of the Asian players, regardless of the ranking, they train hard, very, very hard. And when they are coming to Europe, especially for the first time, they're very well prepared and tend not to fear anyone. So I don't know if the girl will be that worried about the difference in world ranking. Again, a bad decision there by Kirsty on the back line. Just looking for it to fall out, but
I think the drift may have held it in, Craig, yeah. But it did look a fair bit in for this level of player to have left it. That was a very good close net shot from Kirsty, and it was an exceptional lift from the Japanese girl. Put Kirsty right on the baseline.
Very close call as well.
I did just think it was out, but I would like to have seen it from in line with it. But there we go.
Nah,
that
yeah,
was
hit the line. Hit the line.
That's better. That's it, stop it on the net rather than hit at the girl, because she's very good at getting it over Kirsty after that. Well played and well left.
At this point in the game, Dan, you're looking for Kirsty to show her experience and continue to push through. I don't think she'll have it easy.
No, she won't, but I'm sure she's played a number of Japanese girls in the past, and she'll know that they're very fit and they keep fighting all the time. You have to win every point against them. They give very few things away, very few unforced errors. Again, a very good lift from the Japanese girl off a very good net shot from Kirsty.
Good defense by the Japanese girl, gets a lot back.
Very good, but that'll have taken a lot out of both players. I just hope it's not taking too much out of Kirsty.
I think at this level, Dan, it's about being able to win a rally like that and then putting the pressure back on and doing it again.
Oh! both players happy to take the break there. There, Kirsty just going for the line and just with the drift, just taking the shuttle out of the court. So, this is critical here. Very patient, very good from Kirsty. Got to make this girl move the full diagonal because she's so small, but she's very quick. Kirsty was hoping the drift would just carry that out the side.
Tight match, 19 all. Again, we're looking for Kirsty to make sure that she continues with positive play and doesn't shy off from actually taking the victory in the first set. Excellent. That's good.
That was good, but I do feel she looks just a little bit slower than she was at the start, but she's a very good athlete, so I'm sure there's a lot more in the tank. But I'd like to see her take the game more attacking. But she has to be patient for it, but when the chance comes, she's got to go for it. Good and very patient from Kirsty there, and well left at the baseline to take the first set 21-19.
Yeah. To me, it almost looks like Kirsty doesn't feel that the girl can actually attack her with smashes, so she's prepared to be patient and play a sort of corner style game. But she's playing some very high clears. But in the contrast, the Japanese girl started trying to play a little bit flatter to stop Kirsty from playing these attacks. So, second set could be interesting.
I wonder if Kirsty's style of play will change now that she's got onto the... She's hitting against the drift. Or will she just continue? Because when you hit into a drift and you hit cuts, the drift tends to bring the shuttle down steeper than it does normally when you're hitting into the wind. So I'll be interested to see if she cuts more or has more power or whatever, how she approaches this game.
Yeah, I think, the higher clears at the back was almost, I'm pretty patient, I'm pretty confident, but as you change sides, like you said, Anne, it could be a difficult one for her. But I'd still like to see her get back to the style that she used to control on the net and attacking, and that'll give her a chance to play some of the cuts and slices that you mentioned. think we also mentioned the experience. Kirsty's played in this arena a number of times, won a Commonwealth medal last year at the Glasgow 2014 Commonwealth Games, and I think she should be fairly comfortable. And anyone that continues and wants to continue to tweet us, you can find us on hashtag SOGP. So, second game, first game to Kirsty Gilmour, 21-19. We talk about the rankings, Dan, of the players, which obviously in the Japanese girl being 129, Rio's not really an option for her in the short term, but knowing the Japanese system, she's possibly someone they're looking for the future. But if Kirsty's to move from being 20 in the world to that top 10, what do you feel she's got to do in the coming couple of years?
I feel she has to work on deception overhead. I think she's a fantastic athlete. I think she's quick, and that was just an example there of the strength in her legs when she jumped up and clipped that shuttle down. It was superb. But I do think she has to work on deception overhead from the back of the court, making all the strokes look so similar that you can't tell what's coming. That's what I would like to see her do. I still don't like that serve, but it does very well for her. Now this is interesting, because now the Japanese girl's hitting with the wind behind her, and if Kirsty keeps doing that, all clears and drops, etc., obviously the shuttle will stay in more at the back of the court, but if the girl decides to hit it, then she's got more force.
Yeah.
So the cuts come down quicker, although they're deeper into court, they come down quicker, and the smashes come down quicker, so it'll be interesting.
But again, even so early on, Kirsty's already started with some punch clears, trying to play flatter into the corner and take the forecourt much earlier, so maybe she's changed a little. And like many good players, the Japanese girl, even when she's forced and it looks like she's going to hit backhand, she's able to have a good racket carriage and go round the head and still find that control.
Yep, and the question here is, will Kirsty have the focus? And I think she should have, to be able to cope with this, because she's going to have to earn every point she gets from this girl. That was just indecision from the Jap. She had there. She had too much time to think what she was going to do with it. And she obviously doesn't think that there's any particular area of weakness with Kirsty, or she would have played it into it right away. But she's maybe struggling for ideas, and it's just a war of attrition. Very uncharacteristic error there from a Japanese player. Third or fourth shot of the rally out.
I think we talked about Rio 2016, but it's worth mentioning that we have World Championships, BWF World Championships coming to Glasgow, will be played in this arena. So I'm sure many of the players are thinking ahead to 2 years down the line and having to come back and play in the Scottish Open and then get that exposure to the hall. But again, it's going to be held in this arena, so that should be another great event.
That was a lovely shot from the Japanese player. Had a little double action or a dummy to kid on. She was going to lift off the net. Kirsty just held her position in the centre of the court and she played back on the net. So this won't be an easy game. It's pretty tough out there at the moment. Could do with a few more of those. Kirsty knows the girl can't hurt her as long as she's focused. If she doesn't have an extraordinary smash or deception overhead. But Kirsty's just got to stay focused long enough and then take the chances. That's nice. It. Take the chances when they come.
I think you're right, Dan. The focus is one thing, but the rallies, especially the girl, is very, very good. So the rallies are going to be tough, but if you can stay in long enough and be patient, put pressure on pressure, you'll pick up points.
Yep.
You can see how short that was there for Kirsty to play the winner.
Yeah, and although it's very physical, and she will be feeling it inside your head when you know that somebody can't hurt you. It's just, it's down to you. It's not, for me, it's not what the Japanese girl does here that's going to determine the outcome. It's about Kirsty. If she doesn't make mistakes, she will win. She's got a lot more firepower. The girl's small. If she hits close to the lines, the girl's struggling to get there. So she's got to do that when she's on balance and she's got an opportunity to put the girl under real pressure. That was just bad preparation for Kirsty there that caused that. Side to hit that straight lift in because the wind would carry it back into court, and a lovely cross lift there. Flat, making the Japanese player do all sorts of work there to try and get to it. Very good.
I think last year, Dan, Kirsty lost to one of the Japanese girls as well. I don't think she's here this year, but they just seem to continue to bring out many, many good, strong singles players.
That's a, I think Kirsty should just have hit that straight. As long as she can get height, the girl can't hurt her from the back of the court. An injection of pace, and she should be too quick for the girl, I think.
Yeah, that's what she's good at.
But she's just got to be patient, got to build a rally, then go for it. If she's successful, fine. If she's not, then keep building. Don't keep forcing and forcing when you're out of position. Just be patient.
I think as Kirsty's got more experience over the last couple of years, she used to be attacking the whole time, but now she's patient enough, as you say, and then when she gets the chance, she's able to do it. So when she's playing well, she's really, really effective, taking things from the top of the net and then using the jump and the angles and the power to win the rallies. She did it there.
It's a good shot. Good shot.
Smash.
That's a great smash again. Very close to the line. It's the quality and the pace of the shot that's beating the girl.
You can see sometimes when some of the players, when you see Kirsty jump in there, as soon as a player is extending up and you know they've got power, it makes it more difficult, even the thought process of having to take the smash. You don't know what's coming and then bang. Good accuracy from Kirsty.
Trying to play too soft into the drift. Just push it forward. So it's still there, it's a very tough game. Lovely net. Post the error. Good spin net. And that's it, she just needs to be patient because in the first set, she was getting in trouble when she was hitting off the net at the Japanese girl and she was getting it over her head. Just play the net to keep it simple.
She's getting a bit anxious there. She's been patient up to this point, but she going for the lines when it's possibly not an option.
Well left, and you could clearly see the drift just carrying it out to the right-hand side of the court there. That was good from Kirsty Gilmour.
You can see these long rallies, Dan, are pretty punishing for both players, but again, as you said, they're pretty much fit enough to do it. But pressure on pressure, I'm expecting Kirsty to put another rally like that back in and get to the break.
Very good shot from the Japanese girl again. See Kirsty sweating a great deal there. She's never afraid to put the work in. That's what I like about her. I think the umpire should let them wipe the court here because the length of time it's taken Kirsty to do it with her feet. Very good there. She's asking for the court to be wiped now.
So at the moment, Dan, we're last quarter final ladies singles. The winner of this match will play Anathea Madsen, one of the young Danish players. The other semi-final, Lena Kiersfeldt. We'll play second seed Beatrice Corrales. So at the moment there's some quality player through to the semi-final, and this will complete the lineup, the winner of this match.
And although the rallies are long and hard, I think that Kirsty is very fit and she recovers well in between. So just hope the Japanese girl's got nothing new in her locker and you should be all right as long as Kirsty's patient enough. Just out.
I think just watching the Japanese girl, she's very, very quick. I think you see the feet are moving well. She's always looking to get there as quick as you can, but some players are slightly slower but still effective, but she's someone that looks very, very, very quick.
Good, lovely net shot from Kirsty there, just clipping the tape. It went 12-11. She will need to keep working. This is a tough game. And that one goes just against her, run across the net tape there, but just didn't fall over. And you can see there that the Japanese girl must be under 5 feet tall. So that's a big court to cover when you're that height. That's a good smash.
The Japanese girl, Dan, is one of 35 Japanese girls that are on the world ranking list at the moment. And it gives you an indication, I think, if you're able to come through that system, where you've even got 35 women singles players that are out and about in the world, you're going to be pretty tough before you arrive. So it's no surprise. This girl at the moment probably within the top 10 in Japan. But... it does help when you've got a good system behind you.
Yep, and when they're playing their nationals or whatever, they must be so tired at the end of a weekend or a week-long event, because every game will be long and hard because they're quick, they cover the court well, everything. But it must take a certain mindset when you go out there and you know you haven't got a winner in your locker and you're just trying to wear somebody down all the time. That's what I feel as a watcher. I think she hasn't got a shot that's... If Kirsty came off here and you asked her, where did you worry about...
Very good.
Where would you worry about hitting the shuttle to the Japanese girl? I don't think there's anywhere she wouldn't be saying, I can't lift round her head, she's got this shot or she's got that shot. I don't think she has the weapons to hurt her, but what she does have is a massive heart and the attitude. And she's just trying for everything there. You could see her down on the ground and getting back up again. Kirsty up the pace a little after that short break. It's a tough one, all right, 14-all. That was just long. She's watching it carefully. Into the drift. there again. Any time there's a smash close to the line, the Japanese girl invariably doesn't get there, but it has to be a really high quality smash.
It's good that Kirsty's actually looking for that there. She's playing the reverse, hoping that the lift's going to come back up. So again, not letting it, 15-14.
Once again, good smash at the body. Didn't come back. It's the first time I've seen the Japanese girl show any emotion there, that just letting the shoulders drop. Trying to gee herself up again at the moment.
I think for Kirsty at this stage in the match, to get an easy point within the first three is always a bonus.
And she's been given that. Well, that's good. Oh. I think the Japanese girl thinks it's... No, she doesn't. She doesn't. She realises it was in. It was well in.
So this being a quarter-final match, Dan. Semi-finals will take place tomorrow. Emirates Arena, 12 o'clock start. So if you're out there and you want to come see some great badminton, get yourself out to the Emirates.
Absolutely. And this... The badminton, you'll see, will not be the pit part of the local sports centre. This is high quality stuff, served up by real athletes. Very good, very good. See, when she doesn't make mistakes and keeps her focus, she's a terrific player to watch. Match point, Kirsty Gilmour. And that's it, Kirsty Gilmour, 21-19, 21-14. And that was a hard, tough battle.
Yeah, you can see she's pretty pleased, Dan, but it's a tough win. It's winning the first set 21-19 and then second to 14, so she'll be glad to get over in two sets and start preparing again for tomorrow.
You can see she's delighted at that victory there. Hands in the air, throws the racket. That's a hard battle, and she'll be relieved. Yep, it's only two sets, but it will have taken a lot out of her. But she'll recover by tomorrow. So Scotland's Kirsty Gilmour through to the semi-finals tomorrow afternoon. Well done, Kirsty.
So a win there for Kirsty Gilmour. We will take a short break and we'll be back in a couple of minutes with men's singles quarterfinal. Emil Holz from Denmark against Rajiv Usef from England.